Hey guys, this is Abhishek from gadgetshoot.com and today we are going to do a benchmark and gaming review of Samsung Galaxy S4. We have installed couple of benchmarking utilities on this device including Intuitu Benchmark, NinaMark and Quadrant Standard, and let me just show you the score for the Intuitu Benchmark first of all. So the score for the Intuitu Benchmark is pretty good, as you can see, and it is pretty high in terms of the overall scores which we have seen on other Android devices. Here we have the detailed scores, and as far as the detailed scores are concerned, the CPU and RAM has performed pretty well. As far as the benchmark is concerned on Intuitu, this device ranks at a very nice position. This is how the device ranks when it comes to the other devices, as you can see, and it is above HTC One and Sony Xperia Z in terms of the ranking. And this is how the scores looks like for the Quadrant Standard utility. And on the Quadrant Standard, this device has performed really good. The total score is 13077, which is quite good. And this is how the device ranks when it comes to comparing it with other devices. It is at the top as compared to any other device out there. And this is how the detailed scores looks like on the device as far as the CPU, memory, input-output operation, 2D and 3D is concerned. On NinaMark, this device scores a score of 59.8 FPS, which is very good score when it comes to the overall FPS which we can get. That means it should be able to run all the graphic intensive games, and we have installed couple of bench heavy graphic intensive games on this device. Now when it comes to the games, we have installed couple of heavy graphic intensive games as well as the casual games on this device. Let's start our review with the Frontline Commando. So the game is now loaded and I do not notice any problem with the graphics till now. So the touch screen is fairly responsive. I do not notice any lag with the touch screen or with the graphics till now. As you can see, the device is running this game without any problem. I do not notice any lag. Here we have another game which is called the Frontline Commando D-Day, and this game is again quite graphic intensive when it comes to the overall graphics if we talk about. And let's see how does this device handle this game. Now for all those who would like to know the load time, this game takes less than 30 seconds to load before you can actually start playing it. I do not notice any kind of graphic lag till now. Now let's try some racing game, and we have Need for Speed Most Wanted, which is one of the very graphic intensive game when it comes to racing. We also tried installing Asphalt 7. Asphalt 7 also ran pretty fine, but we don't have that game as of now. Let me just show you the performance of the Need for Speed on this device. We'll be right back. So as you can see, there is no problem with the graphics till now on the device while playing this game. And the game is quite fast when it comes to graphic rendering, as you can see. And the sound which is coming out from the loudspeaker is also quite loud. Till now, I find this device fairly good for gaming. There is no game which I can think of which is not supported on this device. And there is no graphic glitch of any kind, even when I'm running the high graphic intensive game like Need for Speed Most Wanted. I do not notice any kind of lag in the draw distance or the graphics, as you can see. Now here we have a casual game called Beach Buggy Blitz, and let's try playing this game. Again, this game should run fine without any problem, but let's see how does this game actually performs. So as you can see, the graphics which I can see on the screen are pretty fine, nice and clear. There is no issue at all. And the game performance is pretty good. See, this game is also running fine without any issues, and the graphics are also pretty good. Now the last game which we are going to play is Dead Trigger, and let's see how does this game performs on this device. Now for all those who would like to know the load time of this game takes less than 30 seconds to load. So as you can see, this game also runs fine on this device. There is no graphic lag or glitch which we have noticed on this device till now while playing any of the graphic intensive game, including Modern Combat 4, Need for Speed and some other games which we just demoed you. So this device is fairly good when it comes to the overall gaming performance. One thing I would like to share is that the device becomes fairly hot at this particular point whenever you are playing some graphic intensive game, or whenever we are playing games for a longer duration of time, for more than 20 to 25 minutes, you will notice that this device becomes quite hot at this point. And we have done a video on, you can watch that. That's all from us. Do let us know you have any specific question for this device as far as gaming is concerned. If you like this video, you can click the like button below. You can subscribe to our VT Video channel for more videos like this by clicking the subscribe button below. Thanks for watching this video. This is Abhishek signing off. Thank you.